नमस्कार एक्सलेंसी, इस वर्चुअल समिट के माध्यम से आपसे बात करने का अवसर मिल रहा है, इसकी मुझे बहुत प्रसन्नता है। सबसे पहले मैं डेनमार्क के कोविड-19 के कारण हुई क्षति के लिए संवेदना व्यक्त करता हूं। इस संकट से निपटने में आपके कुशल नेतृत्व का अभिनंदन भी करता हूं। सभी व्यस्तताओं के बीच आपने इस वार्तालाप के लिए समय निकाला, यह हमारे आपसी रिश्तों के प्रति आपके विशेष फोकस और कमिटमेंट को दर्शाता है। हाल ही में आपका विवाह हुआ, मैं इसके लिए आपको मंगलमय शुभकामनाएं देता हूं और आशा करता हूं कि कोविड-19 से उत्पन्न स्थिति सुधारने के बाद शीघ्र ही हमें आपका सपरिवार भारत में स्वागत करने का अवसर मिलेगा। मुझे विश्वास है कि आपकी बेटी ईदा फिर से भारत आने के लिए अवश्य आतुर होगी। कुछ महीने पहले फोन पर हमारी बात बहुत प्रोडक्टिव हुई थी। हमने कई क्षेत्रों में भारत और डेनमार्क के बीच सहयोग बढ़ाने के बारे में चर्चा की थी। ये प्रसन्नता का विषय है कि आज हम इस वर्चुअल समिट के माध्यम से इन इरादों को नई दिशा और गति दे रहे हैं। डेनमार्क 2009 से, जब मैं गुजरात का मुख्यमंत्री था, वाइब्रेंट गुजरात समिट में लगातार सम्मिलित हो रहा है। इसलिए डेनमार्क के प्रति मेरा विशेष लगाव भी रहा है। मैं दूसरे इंडिया नॉर्डिक समिट को होस्ट करने के आपके प्रस्ताव के लिए आभारी हूं। स्थिति सुधरने के बाद डेनमार्क आना और आपसे मिलना मेरे लिए सौभाग्य की बात होगी। एक्सलेंसी, पिछले कई महीनों की घटनाओं ने यह स्पष्ट कर दिया है कि हमारे जैसे लाइक माइंडेड देशों का जो एक रूल्स बेस्ड, ट्रांसपेरेंट, ह्यूमैनिटेरियन और डेमोक्रेटिक वैल्यू सिस्टम शेयर करते हैं, साथ मिलकर काम करना कितना आवश्यक है। वैक्सीन डेवलपमेंट में भी लाइक माइंडेड कंट्रीज के बीच कोलैबोरेशन से इस पैंडेमिक से निपटने में मदद मिलेगी। इस महामारी के दौरान भारत की फार्मा उत्पादन क्षमताएं पूरे विश्व के लिए उपयोगी रही है। हम यही प्रयास वैक्सीन के क्षेत्र में भी कर रहे हैं। हमारे आत्मनिर्भर भारत अभियान का भी यही प्रयास है कि प्रमुख आर्थिक क्षेत्रों में भारत की क्षमताएं बढ़े और वे विश्व के भी काम आए। इस अभियान के तहत हम ऑलराउंड रिफॉर्म्स पर जोर दे रहे हैं। रेगुलेटरी और टैक्सेशन रिफॉर्म से भारत में काम करने वाली कंपनीज को लाभ मिलेगा। अन्य क्षेत्रों में भी रिफॉर्म्स की प्रक्रिया निरंतर चालू है। हाल ही में कृषि और लेबर सेक्टर्स में महत्वपूर्ण रिफॉर्म्स किए गए हैं। एक्सलेंसी, कोविड-19 ने दिखाया है कि ग्लोबल सप्लाई चेन्स का किसी भी सिंगल सोर्स पर अत्यधिक निर्भर होना कितना रिस्की होता है। हम जापान और ऑस्ट्रेलिया के साथ मिलकर सप्लाई चेन को डाइवर्सिफाई करना और रेजिलियंस के लिए काम कर रहे हैं। अन्य लाइक माइंडेड देश भी इस प्रयत्न में जुड़ सकते हैं। इस संदर्भ में मेरा मानना है कि हमारी वर्चुअल समिट न सिर्फ भारत डेनमार्क संबंधों के लिए उपयोगी सिद्ध होगी, बल्कि वैश्विक चुनौतियों के प्रति भी एक साझा अप्रोच बनाने में मदद करेगी। एक बार फिर से एक्सलेंसी, आपके समय के लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद करता हूं। अब मैं आपको अपने ओपनिंग रिमार्क्स के लिए आमंत्रित करना चाहता हूं।
डियर प्राइम मिनिस्टर, योर एक्सलेंसी, आई एम वेरी प्लीज्ड विद दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर अस टू मीट। इट इज एन ऑनर फॉर अ स्मॉल कंट्री लाइक डेनमार्क टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ इंडियाज फर्स्ट ग्रीन स्ट्रेटेजिक पार्टनरशिप। We need to tackle this crisis together, and I believe that today's meeting is a very clear symbol and a very important symbol of our shared ambition. So thank you so much. I recall with great pleasure our very friendly and our very personally and constructive telephone conversation in May. And thank you so much for the greetings to my family. I can tell you that my daughter will love to visit India once again, and it goes for the whole family. Thank you so much. I would also like to congratulate you on your recent birthday. Congratulations also on the marking of Mahatma Gandhi's 150 years birth anniversary on October the 2nd. We have had historical bilateral relations for 400 years. Well, not the two of us, but our two countries. And glad that the 400 year anniversary will be marked later on this year on a virtual celebration. This will make our bilateral ties even stronger. Today's summit marks for Denmark a milestone on our bilateral relations, on an important and forward-looking agreement on green strategic partnership. We are so proud of this meeting, and we are also very proud that we, as a very small country, is a country that India looks into when it comes to the climate changes. Let me also take this opportunity, of course, to express my condolences for the loss of many lives in India due to the COVID-19. I think we have seen a great leadership in India, and we recognize and we know that it is a very, very difficult time for you. So I would like to express my feelings and my condolences. This pandemic is a serious global challenge for all of us, and it affects all of us. And cooperation is so important, directly, bilateral, but also, as you said, multilateral, as a world society. And it is true that we are like-minded countries when it comes to the support of a global world society based on multilateral ideas and values. With India and Denmark joining hands together today, I am confident that we are able to overcome both the situation when it comes to COVID-19, but also when it comes to climate changes. And because of that, we are able in our cooperation to build a better future for our people. Thank you so much.
Står rent faktisk her med aftalen, og det er jo ikke en aftale, der med det samme giver klingende mønt fra Danmark. Vi skulle ud og slås for de ordre, men bare det, at relationen mellem Danmark og Indien nu er så god, at man kan gå ud og give en anden håndslag på, at Danmark har kompetencer inden for det grønne, altså inden for klimaløsning og andet, jamen det åbner jo en kæmpemæssig mulighed til et meget, meget stort marked. Indien har i dag 1,4 milliarder indbyggere og er ved at passere Kina som det mest folkerige land, verdens mest folkerige demokrati, og de står med de samme kolossale udfordringer, som vi har set med Kina tidligere, altså at skulle løfte en meget, meget stor del af befolkningen fra fattigdom og op til at være middelklasse. Og det betyder jo, at de kompetencer, som Danmark har, dem viser vi allerede på fornem vis i Indien. Det gælder for eksempel Vestas, som eksporterer vindmøller. Det gælder A.P. Møller Mærsk, som bruger indiske havne, og det gælder også en lang række andre teknologier.
Danmark og Indien har indgået en aftale om nyt grønt samarbejde. Det skete på et virtuelt topmøde mellem Indiens premierminister Narendra Modi og statsminister Mette Frederiksen. Og partnerskabet omfatter løsninger inden for grøn energi, vand samt klima- og miljøudfordringer.
Danmark og Indien har indgået et nyt grønt samarbejde. Det skete på et virtuelt topmøde mellem Indiens premierminister Narendra Modi og statsminister Mette Frederiksen. Partnerskabet omfatter især løsninger for grøn energi, vand samt klima- og miljøudfordringer.
1,3 milliarder indere, som alle sammen gerne vil have adgang til vedvarende energi og til ren drikkevand, og kigger nu i Danmarks retning. Det er ganske, ganske enestående.
Namaskar and good evening. Welcome to the special briefing. We have just concluded the India-Denmark virtual summit between our PM and Prime Minister of Denmark. To brief us on this summit, I have with me Joint Secretary Central Europe, Srimati Neeta Bhushan. May I invite Joint Secretary to make her opening remarks, following which we will respond to your questions. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Anurag. Good evening to all of you. Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi and Denmark's Prime Minister, Her Excellency Mrs. Mette Frederiksen, held their first ever virtual summit today. The meeting lasted for about an hour. This was the first such virtual summit that was held with any country in EU bilaterally. The discussions between the two Prime Ministers were held in a very friendly and cordial atmosphere. There was very good chemistry between the two Prime Ministers. In the current COVID-19 pandemic scenario, the successful conduct of the virtual summit shows the high degree of commitment the two leaders attached to strengthening our bilateral relations. Both the Prime Ministers recall the teleconversation that was held on 14th May, during which they had exchanged views on the COVID-19 situation and the way forward. Our Prime Minister thanked the Danish Prime Minister for her offer to host the second Nordic summit in Copenhagen and conveyed that he would be happy to visit Denmark once the COVID situation improves. He also invited the Danish Prime Minister to visit India soon. Both sides noted with satisfaction the continued development of bilateral relations based on historical links, common democratic traditions and shared values of democracy, pluralism, inclusivity and freedom. The two Prime Ministers agreed to elevate India-Denmark relations to a green strategic partnership. Our Prime Minister stated that this is a new age partnership and will add a new dimension to our bilateral relations. This will also help to expand economic relations and green growth and strengthen cooperation on addressing global challenges and meet opportunities with focus on the implementation of the Paris Agreement and the UN Sustainable Development Goals. Our Prime Minister also said that the concept of circular economy should be added and time-bound action plan needs to be drawn up. Prime Minister proposed setting up of an India-Denmark energy park in areas where there are large number of Danish companies. He also proposed setting up of India-Denmark Skill Institute so that the Danish companies will be able to get skilled manpower as per their requirement. Both sides highlighted the strong trade and investment links. Over 140 Danish companies are present in India and are participating in the Make in India initiative. Our Prime Minister also stated that Danish companies have started making in India for the world, which is extremely welcome. He also mentioned that he had given the mantra, Denmark has the skills and India has the skill. Now he would like to add that we need to expand the scope and the skills and the speed, add speed to this mantra. He also welcomed Denmark into the International Solar Alliance. A large number of regional and multilateral issues were also discussed. There is a joint statement which is being released shortly. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I'll move on to the questions which we've received. Manish Jha from Business World. He wants to know India-Denmark virtual summit results in signing green partnership with India. What exactly the green partnership pertains to and what is the action plan to achieve such objective?
This is the first agreement of this kind. It will help in expanding cooperation in renewable energy, environment, circular economy, water and waste management, in reducing air pollution, etc. So several sectors have been identified on which both sides will cooperate to increase our collaborations, joint ventures and technology transfers, etc. The action plan, as you heard, will be drawn up so that we have some specific targets for the next few years on this.
The next one is from Maha from CNN News 18. Danish companies have set up some waste-to-energy facilities to deal with paddy stubble. Do they also wish to invest in the overall management of paddy stubble, the first being low-cost stubble extractors? Do these companies have an overall wholesome solution that can be offered to India as it deals with this recurring problem of air pollution due to stubble burning?
Danish companies have a lot of niche technologies and expertise in such areas, and they have offered to help us in meeting our targets of reducing air pollution. And I think that Danish companies are already looking and talking to our companies on how to take this forward.
Siddhant from Vion wants to know, on COVID crisis, what kind of discussions took place? Any specifics on COVID vaccine?
The COVID crisis was definitely mentioned, and the Danish Prime Minister said that the scale at which it is being handled in India cannot be imagined, and she expressed deep appreciation for our Prime Minister's leadership in that context. On the issue of vaccine, it was mentioned that collaboration between like-minded countries will help to meet the challenges of this pandemic. And India is well known for its pharmaceutical capabilities, and we are working in the field of vaccine development as well.
Manish Jha from Business World, his question is, was there any discussion on EU-India FTA? What are the issues discussed? And what is Denmark's position in resolving tariff and fresh talks with India EU?
This issue was discussed, and it was agreed that both sides will work to an early conclusion of the bilateral broad-based trade and investment agreement.
Siddhant from Vion. He has another question. Was the extradition of Kim Davey discussed by the Indian side?
Yes, it was mentioned, and it was agreed that the concerned officials on both sides will be in touch with each other, and that both sides will work for the early resolution of the issue.